Hello friends, I am Dr. Ravindra Patil, working as scientist at Genetics and Plant Breeding Group of Agarkar Research Institute, Pune. Our group is engaged in improvement of crop productivity without sacrificing ecological and economical sustainability. The institute is one of the leading centers for improvement of crops such as wheat, soybean and grapes under the All India Coordinated Research Projects funded by ICAR New Delhi. The diverse challenges and constraints such as changing climatic conditions, increasing food demand, natural resource degradation, biotic and abiotic threats to the crop, and changing consumer food habit demand a paradigm shift in the crop improvement program. Our group is mainly focusing on development of genetic and genomic resources useful in the crop improvement program. Recent advances in genomics are leading to identification of hundreds of genes governing response to abiotic and biotic stresses, end-use quality and nutritional quality in crop. Therefore, it is essential to integrate this information in crop breeding to develop next generation crop varieties. So, our major objective involves identification and utilization of genetic stocks for various agronomically important traits, development of functional markers for desired trait or phenotype with high breeding value, and their deployment in crop improvement program. Today I will discuss about mapping of QTL or gene for desired trait, development of DNA based marker and their application in marker assisted breeding. I will also discuss about development of EMS mutagenized population in wheat and identification of mutant by tilling. So mapping of a particular gene starts with development of mapping population. The mapping population may be a backcross population, a recombinant inbred line population or a double haploid population as shown in this figure. So in our work we prefer using recombinant inbred line population. So once we develop a mapping population, we have to extract genomic DNA from each of the lines for generation of genotype data using DNA based markers. You can see the segregation of marker in the population in this figure. This genotype data for each marker is recorded and recombination frequencies are calculated to estimate genetic map distances. This information is used for construction of genetic linkage map for all the markers and phenotypic traits recorded in the segregating population. This is an example of mapping a QTL for carotenoid contents in durum wheat. Carotenoids impart bright yellow color to the pasta, which is preferred by the consumer. Therefore, high carotenoid content is preferred trait as far as the pasta industry is concerned. We have developed a genic SSR marker for the selection of phytoin synthase gene associated with high carotenoid content. And further, we have used this particular marker in marker assisted breeding for high carotenoid content in durum wheat. So this is a schematic presentation of marker assisted introgression of high carotenoid content in durum wheat varieties. This is the data of marker assisted derived improved line showing carotenoid content higher than the recipient varieties. Presently, we are engaged in fine mapping and marker assisted breeding for alternative dwarfing genes RHT14 and RHT18 to develop semi-dwarf wheat genotype suitable for conservation agriculture. Semi-dwarf wheat with alternative dwarfing gene can emerge through the earlier crop residues, and wheat with improved emergence capacity also helps to reduce stubble burning incidences. We have also established a platform to obtain EMS induced mutants in wheat and their detection by tilling. We are using this approach to develop a new semi-dwarf wheat with improved early vigor suitable for conservation agriculture. We are thankful to Department of Science and Technology, SERB, ICAR and DBT for funding our research. For further detail, please contact us at aripune.org. You can also reach to us via email. Thank you for watching this video.